The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 1 through 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 25th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Arjuna Vacha Prakitin Purushan Chaiva Chetram Chetrangancha Evacha Ketat Veditam Ichami Jnanam Jeyam Chakesam. So four questions Arjuna wanted to know from Krishna, the answers of four questions. First, Prakriti, this material nature, Purusham, the enjoyer of the material nature, Chetram, the field of enjoying or field of activities, and Khetragya, one who is enjoying or one who is acting on the field. Etat devito michyami jnanam jeyam chakesam. Another two things. Jnanam, what is knowledge? And jeyam, what is the object of knowledge? The aim of knowledge. So Krishna replied, idam shariram kauntiya chetram iti avidhiyat. This body is chetra. Etat ja vetti tanga prahu khetragya iti tadvidah. And one who knows this body, he is khetragya. The whole subject matter of Bhagavad Gita is to know who is the proprietor of this body. Generally, everyone, 99.9%, everyone knows that I am this body. But that is not the fact. The owner of the body, one who knows that I am not this body, but I am the proprietor of the body. Basically, I am sitting on this throne. I am not this throne, but I am a different person who is sitting on the throne. Similarly, when somebody asks me what you are, if I give my identification, with this body, that is my foolishness. In the Shastra it is said, jasyātma buddhi kunapi tridhātuke sadhik kalatra disubhoma ijyadhi jatītha buddhi salile nakarhiche janesu abhigyesu saeva gokhara. Gokhara, go means cow, and khara means ashes. Person who is identifying this body as the self. This body is a bag of three dhatu, kapha, pitta, vayu. According to Ayurvedic treatment, this body is made of kapha, pitta, vayu. Otherwise, we can take it, this body is made of flesh, bone, blood, urine, stool, cough. If you analytically study this body, you'll find these are the ingredients of the body. Therefore, these ingredients are not myself. This is a first ignorance. In spiritual knowledge, unless one understands fully that I am not this flesh, blood, urine, other things in this body, I am separate from. One who knows that I am separate from this body, I am spirit soul, I am the part and parcel of the Supreme Lord, as it is stated, mama ivamsa jiva bhuta, then my knowledge is complete. So, education is given to the students, but this knowledge is absent from the educational institution. Nobody knows that I am not this body. Therefore, Shastra says, anyone who is identifying this body as his self, Tasyatma buddhi kunapi siddhatati, and in relationship with the body, others also, sadhik, thinking they are our own man, sadhik kalatra disu bhoma ijyati, and bhoma, the land of birth, is worshipable, ijyadhi. So this is going on. At the present moment, throughout the whole world, everyone is identifying himself with this body. And the land in which the body is born is taken as worshipable, bhoma ijyadhi. And persons who are in relationship with this body, they are our own men or kinsmen. This is going on. But according to Shastra, anyone who is accepting this identification, body as self and the country or the land as worshipable and the kinsmen or relatives, they are only own men. In this way, this misconception of life is being accepted. Therefore, according to Vedic civilization, this is a civilization of the cows and the asses. Saiva gokhara. So, in other words, it is an animal civilization. So you cannot be happy in animal civilization, in the societies of animals. Just like in the jungle, there are animals. There is no peace. There is always struggle for existence, fight between one animal. Still they are peaceful. But at the present moment, throughout the whole world, we have become less than the animals. Because we do not know what is the basic principle of civilization, what is the ultimate goal of life, what is our perfection, these things we are lacking in knowledge. Therefore, Arjuna inquires, what is jnanam, what is knowledge, and what is the object of knowledge? So Krishna replied that this body, sariram, idam sariram, khetra, this is our field of activities. We have got different types of body. Yesterday I have explained, there are 8,400,000 forms of body. And according to our desire, nature is supplying a type of body for our activity. That is explained in another place in the Bhagavad Gita. Ishara sarvabhutana ridneshe arjuna tishtati. The Lord is situated in everyone's heart. Krishna is situated outside and inside also. Krishna antat bahi, he is situated outside and inside. Simply, we have to make our eyes and senses perfect to see him. Krishna is not invisible, he is visible. But one who has got the eyes to see him, one can see. Otherwise, not. Therefore, in the Brahma Samhita, it is stated, premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santa hridayesu sadaiva vilopayanti. Those who have developed Krishna consciousness, love of Godhead, they can see the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Samasundaram, achinta gunasarupam, the reservoir of all transcendental qualities. achinta gunasara. Achinta means inconceivable. The qualities which Krishna has got, that is inconceivable by us. He has got qualities, just like Krishna says that patram pushpam phalam poyam jumi bhaktya prajacchati tadaham asnami. Now anyone offering Krishna patram pushpam phalam poyam jumi bhaktya prajacchati in devotion. So this quality, how Krishna is eating, just like at the present moment Krishna is offered a dish, how Krishna is eating, that we cannot see, but he is eating. Otherwise, Krishna becomes a liar. He says, tadaham asnami bhakta puritam. Anyone who is offering me in devotion, tadaham asnami, I eat. But how he is eating? It is not that he is not eating, but how he is eating, that he do not know. Therefore, achinta guna sarupam, he has a quality which is inconceivable. Just like our conception of eating, that we can eat through the mouth. Whatever eatables are offered to us, we pick them and put into the mouth. We know this is the process of eating. But Krishna, because he is achinta guna sarupam, he is eating process is different from ours. That is also stated in the Brahma Samhita. Angani jasya sakalendriya vritti manti. He has the limbs of the body, different limbs of the body. They can work also for other limbs of the body. Just like with our eyes, we can see. If I close our eyes, we do not see. But Krishna, even he closes his eyes, he can see everything with his hand. Now this is inconceivable. Achinta guna sarva. That way it is called achinta. Angani jasya sakalendriya vritti manti. So the foodstuff is offered there to Krishna. He is eating by seeing. He can eat through his eyes. Just like we can eat through our mouth, not with our eyes. But Krishna can eat through his eyes, simply by seeing. Then you may argue that the foodstuff is offered, if he has eaten, why it is lying as it is, as it was offered in the beginning. That is answered in the Upanishad. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishyate. Purnasya. Krishna can take the whole plate, but still the whole plate remains. It is not finished. That is spirituality. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishyate. So, this is a great science, spiritual science. Unfortunately, we have no educational system to understand the spiritual science. And especially in this age, everything is godlessness, therefore people are not happy. Our this Krishna consciousness movement is only to make people happy by becoming Krishna conscious, understanding everything in the right ways. That is our mission. Therefore, that is the mission of every devotee. That's why Arjuna is asking here. He knows everything. He is Krishna's friend, personal friend. He is always living with Krishna. There cannot be any ignorance on the part of Arjuna. But he is asking this question just for our benefit. Krishna will answer this question. While Krishna's answers will be taken so seriously, because he is the supreme authority, supreme personality of Godhead. If we receive knowledge from the supreme, then it is perfect knowledge. Just like if you get some knowledge from the superior, one is more educated than you, one is more experienced, that knowledge is perfect. So, in this material world, there may be somebody supreme, But he is not ultimate supreme. But ultimate supreme is Krishna. Ishara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha, Anadi Radi Govinda, Sarva Karana Karana. So, if we receive knowledge from the ultimate supreme, Ishara Parama Krishna, then our knowledge is perfect. If we receive knowledge, second-hand knowledge, that is also good. Second-hand knowledge means one who has received knowledge from Krishna. That knowledge is perfect. But one who speculates, it may be like that, it may be like this, that knowledge is not perfect. So in the modern world, every knowledge is speculative, hypothetical. There is no perfect knowledge. So if you want to be perfectly in knowledge, then you have to take knowledge from the Supreme Personality of Godhead that is here, delivered by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, in the form of Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, Krishna, Arjuna is asking these questions so that people may receive the perfect knowledge from Krishna and their life may be perfect in that way. Idam shariram kauntiya kshetram iti avidhiyate etajya bhitti tang prahu kshetrajna iti tad vidaha kshetrajnanchapi mana vidhi sarva kshetreshu bharata kshetra kshetrajnaya jnanam jattaj jnanam matangamama. This is jnanam. What is that jnanam? Jnanam means to know the kshetrajna, the owner of the body, just like in ordinary sense. If you understand that this is a house and the proprietor of the house is such and such gentleman, and then that knowledge is perfect. So similarly, if we understand what is this body and who is the proprietor of this body, then our knowledge is perfect. So Krishna says that this body, there is the proprietor, the soul, but there is another kshetrajna. Just like a house, there is an occupier and there is an owner. These are very easy to understand. Any house you take in Bombay, there are so many tenants or occupiers, but there is a proprietor also. Similarly, in this body, we are not actually the proprietor. We are simply occupier. Just like if I give my motor car to you for use, you are not proprietor. You are occupier or driver. But the owner is different. Similarly, Krishna says that kshetrajna cha api manavinti. I am also Kshetra. I am the proprietor indirectly of this body. Therefore Krishna's name is Rishikesha. Rishik means senses. And this body is full of senses. So actual proprietor is Krishna, Rishikesha. We are given for use. Therefore we are using this hand. But if the hand is paralyzed with for some reason or other, we cannot repair it. It is not possible. Because the proprietor has withdrawn the power of this hand for activity. Therefore it is no more working. Although I am claiming this is my hand. This is not I hand, this is my hand. Actually it is not my hand. It is Krishna's hand. That is knowledge. So long we are thinking that I am this body or my body, that is not perfect knowledge. When you understand that it is Krishna's body, then it is perfect knowledge. Khetragyanchapi manavidhi sarva khetreshu. Not that Krishna is the proprietor or khetragya only of the human form of body. Sarva khetreshu. There are 8,400,000 different types of body. Krishna is present there. That is also explained in the 14th chapter. Sarvajoni shukantaya sambhavanti murtayaya tasang mahajani brahma aham bija padapita. Just like father makes the body, father gives the seed and mother gives the body. Similarly, Krishna is the supreme father. He has given the seed, just like the father impregnates within the womb of the mother. The seed is given by the father. The mother develops the body. Similarly, in this material world, we have come from Krishna. He is the seed-giving father. And the material nature has given us this body. This is compared with a yantra or a machine. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe arjuna tisthate bhramayam sarvabhutani jantrarurani maya. Jantrarurani maya. So, Krishna has given us his body through the agency of material nature. Though this is a body, this body is just like jantra. So we are seated in this jantra and we are traveling. Jantra Rurani Maya, under the influence of Maya, sitting on this car, this jantra, Brahman Sarvabhutani, we are wandering throughout the whole creation. Sometimes we are getting this body of human form, sometimes we are getting the body of a demigod, sometimes we are getting the body of a rich man, sometimes we are getting the body of a poor man, sometimes we are getting the body of a cat, sometimes of a dog, sometimes so many things, trees, plants, aquatics, there are 8,400,000. This is our position. Dehinasmindatha dehi kaumanam yogunanga jara tatha dehantara prati. As we are changing our body every moment, from childhood to boyhood, boyhood to youthhood. Similarly, by changing this body, we get another body, dehantara prapti. But we do not know what kind of body we are going to get next life. We are blind. This is called ignorance. Generally, they are thinking this body is all in all. There is no reward. No. The example is given here in the Bhagavad Gita. Just like a child has his future, another body, boyhood body. The boy has got his future, another body, young man's body. The young man has got another future, old man's body. Similarly, old man has got another body after death. Tatha dehantara prapti. But people have become so irresponsible that they do not know what kind of body he is going to get next life. He is blind. Therefore, this knowledge is required. How I am getting this body, how I can get better body or lower body, this is knowledge. Not that how to eat, how to sleep, and how to have sex life. This is not knowledge. This knowledge is there in the animals. Ahara nidra bhayamaythanancha. Where to find out one's food, where to sleep, how to have sex life, how to defend. These animals also, they know how to do it. So if we devote our time only for these four principles of bodily one, then we are no better than the cats and dogs. The real knowledge is to know what I am, what is this body, why I am suffering. I want to be happy, but why is suffering such there? Always, some kind of suffering is always there. These are the questions. But people have become so foolish, they do not inquire how to make solution of the sufferings, how to make solution of the problems of the life. They are blindly being led. Andha jatha andhai rupaniyamana stepi satantra urudami madhya nate vidu sartagatin hi vishnu durasayaji bahirathamanina. Durasaya. They are hoping something, that by making arrangement in this material world, they will be happy. Oh, that is not possible. In Western countries, Europe, America, they have made sufficient arrangement Paul, living materially very happy, but that has not been possible. They are also disappointed, confused. So materially you cannot be happy. You must know. You must have full knowledge what you are, what is this body, how you will be happy. Then your life is successful. If you live like cats and dogs and try to adjust things like cats and dogs, that is a waste of life, waste of time. Therefore, kindly try to understand Bhagavad Gita. There is full of knowledge. The knowledge is given by the most perfect, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There is no deficiency in the knowledge received from imperfect person. There are four deficiencies: illusion, mistake, cheating, and imperfectness. So from so many deficiencies, you cannot get full knowledge, perfect knowledge from an imperfect person. You have to receive knowledge from the perfect, then your life will be successful. Therefore, Arjuna is putting so many questions to Krishna, and Krishna will answer these things in the 13th chapter. In all the chapters, Krishna's answers are there. Especially in the 13th chapter, Krishna is giving the knowledge, the knowable objective, the subject matter, and what is this body, who is the owner of the body. So Krishna, here it is said, that Hetangamchapi Manavidhi, he is also there. The Mayavadi philosopher says that there is only one spirit. No, there are two. Krishna says, Cha, Cha means another. And as the living, individual living soul, he is the proprietor of this body. Not proprietor, he is the occupier. Similarly, I also, I have got interest in everybody. Just as a landlord. Landlord has many houses. I may occupy one of the houses. So I have got only interest in that particular house where I am living. But the landlord has got interest in so many houses. So Krishna has got interest not only in my body or your body. He has got interest in each and every body. Because he says, Sarva Jonishu, in every species of life, Sarva Jonishu, Sammavanti Murtayav, Tasana Mahajani Brahma, Ahanga Bija Padakuta. These things have to be understood very clearly, how Krishna is related. He is not related with the human society. He is related with the animal society, dog society, cat society, demigod society, aquatic society, tree society, plant society, insect society, everywhere Krishna. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhese arjuna tishthati. That is, Krishna is claiming here that I am also one of the participants in this body. Hitragdan chapimani viddi. Chetra chetra gnayav jnanam. Jad jnanam. Tad jnanam. If only one tries to understand what is the relationship between this body and the soul, the body and the super soul, Krishna. Krishna, when he says that I am also Kshetraga, he is the super soul, Paramatma. Paramatma. He can know everyone's pains and pleasure. I am the occupier of this body. I know the pains and pleasure of my body, but I do not know the pains and pleasure of your body. Neither you know that the pains and pleasure of my body. Therefore, you are individual, localized. But Krishna is all-pervading. Krishna knows the pains and pleasure of your body. Krishna knows the pains and pleasure of my body. Krishna knows the pains and pleasure of dog's body, cat's body, everyone's body. That is Krishna. Sarva-khetri subhava. Sarva-khetri, he knows everything. That is Paramatma teacher. Paramatma teacher means he is even within the atom. Annantarastham paramanu chayantarastham govindam adipurusam tamaham bhajami. So this subject matter is very interesting. So of course Bhagavad Gita is the ABCD of spiritual knowledge. If we do not understand even the ABCD of spiritual knowledge, then where is the progress? Unfortunately we are neglecting. But it is our duty to propagate this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So we are doing our best and we wish that everyone, especially Indians, should cooperate with this movement. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.